Well, it's all go here. It's been a hectic week again. What were we doing last week? We were looking at astronavigation, talking about Jupiter. Dear me, things have moved on since then. At the beginning of this week, I found myself writing about Viking navigation. I had a lecture to give on Wednesday night at the National Maritime Museum. And you know, I thought to myself, I don't know anything about Viking navigation. What am I doing giving a lecture on it? But actually, nobody else does either. And so it's not so bad. And I did write a book about the Norse North Atlantic voyaging a few years ago, 25 years ago actually, Topsail and Battle Axe. It did okay, the book, and I think it was well received. So I do have something to say on the subject. I gave the lecture and it went okay. It went for a whole hour. And then people started asking questions. And there were some really interesting questions. There was one particularly perceptive one that I think answers a lot of questions. I'm not sure whether the gentleman quite saw it that way or whether he didn't, but it really made me think. And it was a very meaningful conversation. It's really nice at the end of a lecture to get good questions that you don't really know the answer to and chuck it back and forth and find out. Then you move things ahead. So that was terrific. Had a great night. Got home, and now the last couple of days we've spent working flat out to get the new website launched. We started with tomcunliffe.com about 11 or 12 years ago. I built it myself and it was all right, but it worked. It helped the business along, and it was early days of internet, so it managed. But then I got a call about 6 years ago from a lady called Geisha in Germany. And Geisha said to me, "Mr. Cunliffe, I am a sailor and I'm also a person who designs websites, and I think yours could be a lot better. Let me help you." Well, I was going to Hamburg to give a speech, so I gave her breakfast. And she brought along Octi, her husband, who turns out to be a bit of a computer genius. And she is wonderful, wonderful with software. We hit it off. And they did the job. And they did it wonderfully well. So now, 6 years down the pipe, she said, "Your website's looking very cobwebby. I think we ought to sort it out. It was very busy, you know. It was too much stuff on there." So she's built me a new one. And it really has got manic this last few weeks. Absolutely manic. She came over for a couple of days. And we took her up the hill here for a village dinner in the New Forest in the south of England. And it was a different world for her. A bit different from Berlin, I can tell you, meeting my mates from the forest. But she had a great time. And she went home. And she and Roz, my wife, have sorted the site between them. There's been algorithms flying around, things I can't even understand. So many emails have been falling off the back of the box. And finally, it's all done. But what it has shown me is what I knew already, really, that Geisha, my German webmistress, is a woman who does not panic. She's the girl you want on the nasty foredeck on a filthy night. She's never going to lose her cool. We need sailors like that, don't we? And she is one. So I'm proud to have her on board. And Octi's great because he and I sit there on a calm night, sailing along, looking at the sky and discussing our mortality. A great man. So what happens next week after all this? Well, next week we're on the boat. The boat's coming out of the water. I'll do the anti-fouling, and then I've got to get into the bilge and do the seacocks, which I do not fancy, not one bit. Because, you know, I'm 6 feet six, and I'm not as young as I should be. And I've got to crawl down into that bilge and tear these seacocks apart. They're getting awfully stiff. A man must know his boat if he's going to go to sea. And there's no prisoners taken out there. The seacocks have got to be done. I've been putting it off for 2 or 3 years, and this is the time, next week. Goodness knows how I'll get on. There's going to be one, isn't there, that'll stick. There's always one. It's like bolts on an engine. There's always one that burrs and you can't get the nut back on. So I'm going to give it my best shot and we'll see how I do. If necessary, I'll have to find a younger, better looking man to do that difficult one. But I hope it doesn't come to that. I'll let you know how I get on next week. Wish me luck.